Right, hello everybody. Welcome to the winners' bracket final of Group D. And we start off with a blitz for Calcium, who was kicking. Ooh, you know what? Yak set up against the blitz. And it's a real poor kick. He can't really take advantage of this very well at all, Calcium. Not having any guard at all really stings right about now. Oh god, he's going high octane. He's taking the basings. Oh yeah, he can blitz this guy. Okay, he has got a blitz. But it doesn't create a gap. He's gonna dodge away, yeah. Kind of sucks dodging away, but he really doesn't want to. He really doesn't want to get blasted by Tackle Mighty Blow, does he? I wonder if he's going to dodge someone through here. 3-3-2. Probably not. I mean, the thing is, he can just win you the game, can't he? Having a guy dodge through. Or he could just leap. Can't reroll. Oh my god. No, I don't like the reroll actually. He's only got two, hasn't he? I don't really like committing the reroll to it. He's got to base this guy with another player now. No, he had to have him base because he can just free him up. He can also free this guy up as well. So he should have based both tacklers with extra players. Because it's too easy to free the tacklers to get back. Though Yak not bothering with freeing this tackler up, I think I'd have started with this hit, and then if the ogre went stupid, then you've got to free him up, right? But he didn't do that. Luckily, he doesn't go stupid, so he does have the Mighty Blow tackle hit. Yeah, if that catcher had just stood where he was, he would have had to have hit with the catcher over here to try and free up somehow. Doesn't get the knockdown? Does. Oh, no AV break. Yeah, these guys not really doing anything. I think he should have gone more contact. If he was gonna do this leap, committing a reroll to the leap, that was really aggro. I think if you're gonna make that play, you've got to base up everybody, not just a couple like you did. These three guys rolling contact, then that becomes a lot harder to deal with. Oh, there's the gym foul, and that's 10 men max for the rest of the game for Yax. There you go. And now, actually, he's exposed himself, hasn't he? Because now Calcium can get a ton of pressure on. Now he can completely cut his team in half. So while he did recover quite well, he didn't bring his team back together. So that little bit of basing that Calcium did was just enough, wasn't it? A finger of fudge is just enough to give the kids a treat. Oh god, that's really unlucky, isn't it, Cormac? Oh boy. That's not in the way, is it? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I mean, he's just got to be sensible here, hasn't he, and just 2D. He's got to reinforce over here, actually. Maybe he's got, because this is the obvious way to get back. Over here is not getting back anywhere. So maybe he should blitz this lineman. Fucking good playing it by Calcium. I mean, I know it's just what I said, But I think that was good play by me and good play by Calcium. Really nice, really nice. The temptation would have been to have banged one of these guarders. But he didn't. I don't like the block so much, because if that's a push, he's letting him, three dice a catcher. But, yeah. Good, I thought that was definitely the right blitz there. And not the one that I went for initially, but the one that Calcium arrived at. Very good. I do think maybe the dancer could have been over there or something, but I don't think it would have mattered much. Cette formation permet d'avancer sans trop de risque. Ça va être dur de leur arracher le ballon. I mean, to be fair, I am a bash coach that primarily the same as Calcium, but I've definitely played more games with bash teams than I have with elves, so I guess I am similar. but hello Zakara, hello in ruins, hello Madakishtar, hello our Yeti. Yeah, I don't know how he's played in a human team with 11 men. It's been much more riveting, yeah, much more riveting. Calcium played an amazing game for his first game. And now, maybe he's going to make that 3D, I don't know. Probably not. Nice getting to 2D, the tackler, isn't it? Getting him down. Is fantastic. Oh ho ho, and stunned. Beautiful. What he could do is he could move that guy to there, and he could have changed his catcher into a block. That would have been the play, I think. Rather than this blitz that he did. And I know the blitz that he needed the blitz to there though. But he could still put the catcher here. Block the ogre. Don't re-roll it, Cowles. Yeah, that's the problem. Is he going to apple it? Probably should have thought about this for 24 seconds. No. I think the play was to move him to there, block the ogre, get the pow, and then he could have 2D'd this guy. And then he would have been basing the ball with a blodge stepper. Would have been all right. And then he could have just stood this guy up. And okay, you don't want your dancer mighty blood. But if he's punching back, he's not getting forward and stuff. And with that stun, he's gonna have like a good advantage for the turn after. But instead, Yak's doing his thing of just removing a guy every single turn. Oh dear. Classic Yak, 3 turns, 3 removals. I think that was the play there. I think that would have been real nice, the chain into an extra block. And then just, you know, stand up a bit. Like, it's horrible having to base this team, but I think he should have done once he got the stun. And like, he was already playing quite basey after getting the blitz. But I think that stun is what should have made him 100% commit. Does he just go for the uphill here? It's not crazy odds. And if he makes it, it comes out here and he can just fucking score and win. Fuck it. I think this is a time to just say fuck it, you know. Like, he ain't going to stop him conventionally. I don't think if he just plays this normally that he's going to stop him scoring at this point after losing 3 players in 3 turns. Your uphill is like 50-50, yeah, so is he going to do it?
de plaquage.
Yeah. Oh well. Well, that was fucking unlucky, wasn't it? He couldn't have got a 1D, no. Yeah, stand firm. Yeah, exactly, in ruins, yeah. So I think he could have done things differently these last few turns, to be honest. But now the other Mighty Blow tackle is up. And he's already, I mean, he's probably just lie down now, to be fair. Shame he used the reroll for the, for that dodge. No, he didn't use it for the dodge, he used the reroll for the leap on the first turn. Because now he hasn't got the reroll for the one turner. Could still do it, of course. Certain lucky bastards can score one turners without a reroll. Yeah, I think he just gives up on the half now. I think that's the genuinely best play is to give up. Give up sometimes. You know, second half, he can have 10 men for the second half at the moment. And I think he was right to go for it at the start of the half, just because, maybe not the leap. I think the leap was maybe a bit much. But it could have paid off, couldn't it? Once you've done that on turn one, I think you've got to continue it for the rest of the half. And go really balls to the wall, because this team is hard to turn over and score. Like, it is a hard team to turn over and score against for Elves. So maybe he should have kept pushing in the first few turns as hard as he could. But I think now just giving up is the right play. And then second half, can try and stall it. Make it to overtime with some players left. And win. It's not really exciting or positive, but I think it's a somewhat realistic ambition. He can't foul, because already he's on 10, isn't he? He uploaded that, so Kalsim could have 11, and Yak's already definitely on 10. So if Kalsim can make some attrition with his Mighty Blow hits on the LOS on turn 8, two Mighty Blow hits and then another two, you know, if he's outnumbering the humans in the second half, it becomes a lot easier, doesn't it? He can then try and pick off players with a Mighty Blow himself. Gotta hope you don't take 8 cards. Hello, Goliath. No idea who's got the fame. 2 fame for Yak. So Yak probably, if he's got 2 fame, I don't know what his fan factor was. Maybe Yak could have got 3 Lionels instead of the Ogre. I would have liked that. You're famous. Oh no, Kalsim. Oh, that really horrible, wasn't it? Again, I think maybe just make a Mighty Blow hit. You know, he could have 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and then screened him. I think maybe he's making a mighty blow hit with block is better than... I mean, okay, hitting this guy is nice. But without block, it's not good, is it? And giving up the hit if it fails, which gets removed. I mean, it's probably not going to happen even if he's got a reroll, isn't it? It's just that you really need good dice if you don't have a reroll. Oh, God. Interesting formation from Yak. Oh, wow, he can GFI with a tree. Let's go, Calcium. GFI tree blitz. You know he's doing it. 3D with Mighty Blow. If he bangs this tackler out, that's amazing. Gets the pow. Boo. Lame. Yeah, he can make a screen for his dancer as well, can't he? Get the dancer up. That will discourage shenanigans from Yak. Is he gonna stomp him? Looks like he is. Stomp him, man's! Sent off for a stun? This is pretty dodgy because he's gonna get the 50-50 back for the KO anyway. But I guess the good thing is that Yak's had a guy sent off. If only those dice rolls were reversed here. And Yek's got the Apo as well, hasn't he, still? So I think that was a pretty... not great foul. But understandable. Understandable, but... I don't think it was a good move. Wow, is he really going to GFI to hit? Oh no, he's going to hit the tree. Nice, nice. Three kills for Kaz, but he's got two chances to get them back, hasn't he? So. Hopefully he can get them back. Oh, he misses the dancer. Oh, God. Oh. I think he would have taken 10v10. But, it's a bit rough to be down a dancer, isn't it? Good afternoon, this is Scotty. Oh, has Yak got a babe? Oh, he went for a bib instead of a reserve. Oh, that's fucking crazy. You went for a bib instead of a reserve. I hate that. I literally hate that. Literally hate that is that he's taken a babe instead of a 12th man. I fucking hate it. Oh yeah, I didn't realise Yak had the babe. No, in that case it was a terrible foul from Calcio. Yak is a well-known madman, yeah. That's true. He's got the two stand firm as well, so yeah, that makes the one turn almost certainly just not going to happen. I don't think Calcium should even try. He should just try to bang people out. He gets to Mighty Blow Blitz his Mighty Blow Tackler. I would three dice Mighty Blow Blitz his Tackler, to be honest. And then if you get a Riot, go for the touchdown if you get a Riot. Otherwise, go for a three dice Mighty Blow hit on his Mighty Blow Tackler. If you can bang him out. Three dice with a tree against a blitzer. And just hope to bang out good players. Real hard to get the one turn here, isn't it? But Calcium gets the initial 1D power that he needs. Oh no! Oh no, he's got the assist. Right, that's okay. Ooh, I was being stupid then. He gets the push. Oh man. He gets the push. This is just a 1D again, isn't it? He hasn't got a string 3 there. I've got string 3 here, but still only 1D. Oh god, he got uphills him and pals him! Oh my god, Calcium, you fucking mad cunt! He could have just hit with him, couldn't he? 3, 4, 5, 6 to 6. But instead he goes for the 4 on 5. But he's in range. He's in range. Oh, Gymshard. Well, reroll wouldn't have helped him. That was so close, wasn't it? That was so close. Hello, Orylensis. Yeah, I mean, that is what happens, isn't it? I've said that from day one. Wolfbark thought I was just saying it to cover my losses, but I mean, I just think Blitz Pit is a very dicey format. Obviously, people know what they're doing. There's never going to be a gulf in skill, and if there's not a gulf in skill, games are dicier. You put in minute turns and pressure to that. Yeah, Blood Bowl in itself is dicey, but it's more dicey when there's not a, when you're closer to skill, aren't you? That's the thing. Like, if I'm playing my mum, the dice is probably not going to decide the game. But if you've got two comparable players, which, you know, pretty much everybody's comparable in Blitz Pit. Of course, everyone's going to rate, like, PTK the highest or whatever. And, you know, some of the qualifiers, they might rate lower than some of the others or whatever. But really, there's not a lot of difference between anybody in the Blitz Pit. So there's just going to be a lot of dice. That's it. Always is going to be. I mean, there's nothing wrong with that. And obviously, people are going to make more mistakes than other people and stuff. Like, you know, there's plenty of games where people did make loads of mistakes and somebody got clearly outplayed. But there is always going to be a lot of dice. Like, a lot of dice. The fact that they're not getting to make the perfect moves because of the time pressure means that they're going to leave easier shots on and stuff, aren't they, and what have you. But I don't think I don't think, like, this has been dicier than normal or anything. Yeah, in ruins, yeah, that's fair. I mean, I'm not calling her a shitter. It's just that she's never played and never would play. I can safely assume that she's a shitter. This is like a split Dakar, isn't it? He's got half of his team up the field and half back. Nice cheeky removal. No apple. Interesting. Oh, God. You can't re-roll it either, Calcium. Oh, you pure dickhead. Now, no offense, Calcium, but don't. That was a proper fucking werewolf blitz, wasn't it? That was a proper werewolf blitz. Jesus Christ. Calcium necromantic coach in disguise. You just can't make that blitz. You just can't. You should have seen the setup and just taken his mighty blow hit on the LOS and then, you know, screened it off afterwards. Like, this could have been his mighty blow guy and he could have assisted in front, but 2D'd him, screened him off and protected him that way. That was real bad blitz. You hate to see it. Bad dice on the one, but it was real bad decision, I think. Doesn't follow. So only a two dice instead of a three. Doesn't matter. I can move up around here, can't I? Oh, that was horrible. He's got a... He's got to not tilt now, hasn't he? That's the thing after that. He's probably, non-calcium, he's probably raging a tiny little bit that he rolled a one and got KO'd, but he's got to not give a shit about it. Could just be thankful he got the other fucker back, I think. Because if he'd had no dancers now, that would have been really bad. You still got Air Dancer to do things with. And you know, Yak's down to 9, he's down to 10, he's got the man advantage. Just got to keep his head. Not run out of time like that. Oh God. Oh fuck me, Calcium. Oh, you fuck, mate. You are fucked. Oh, Calcium. Oh, he is the banger. Yak the banger starts removing people left, right and centre. Oh, running out of time. It's all gone to rat shit. Almost time to start thinking about the next game now, Calcium. dear me. Especially when this armor break. I mean, you knew it was going to happen, right? There was never any chance of that not being an AV break. Yeah, just got to try and fucking refocus for the third game. This one's pretty much done. I mean, it might be savable. And if anyone can save it, it's Woody's, but it's going to be a lot, isn't it? A turn to put pressure on, then he scores. And then you two turn, you got three turns to turn him over and make overtime. So there's a chance, but a fucking small chance. Doesn't do a whole lot that actually. In fact, it's probably worse than just punching somebody. Concede, yeah, he could concede. He could go the Singolo route, which might be the best play, honestly. Best decision he made all match. That was fucking brutal, wasn't it? Best decision he made all match. Oh, Tom Schnitz. Oh, Wolfpack. Oh, dear. Oh, he's re-rolling it as well. Oh, God, no. No, Calcium, you should not have used any re-rolls. Well, you shouldn't have done this, should you? You should have just concede, mate. Just concede. Rolling double ones. I did! Oh, well. It's fair enough. It's fair enough. Again, like Singolo, it's fair enough. Get it out of the way. Refocus. Refocus, nice. And so Yak's win goes through as the winner of Group D. Congrats to Yak. And then, that was the best decision Calcium made this match. Gives him half an hour or whatever to get himself ready for the final. Yeah, good show. Right. Thanks for watching, everyone. Don't forget to leave a like and subscribe. And stay fantastic.